to adjust the vacuum pressure to obtain the right amount of bubbling, we have two bypass valves in the circuit. When we close the bypass valve, more acetone will be extracted. When we open the bypass valve, less acetone will be extracted. Also, we can monitor the pressure using the digital manometer, but in the end, only the bubbling is important. Impregnation is going in the right speed. When we see bubbles rise, like simmering, not really hard boiling, and also not very slowly, but in between. It's like a stew standing on the stove. Plop, 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 plop. When there are no acetone bubbles, pressure in the vacuum chamber is too high, or the vacuum is not low enough. So we should close the bypass valve a little bit to see what's happening, and we can close it until the bubbles reappear. When there are too many acetone bubbles, like boiling potatoes, it's wise to open the bypass valve, then the pressure will rise and the bubbling will slow down. When impregnation goes too fast for a prolonged time, too much acetone will be extracted from the tissue without the resin given the opportunity to come into the tissue, and the result will be shrinkage of the specimen.